So this is a Lego Mindstorm robot, which we've hacked together into a semi-autonomous robot, which should be able to drive around the room on its own. This robot is a Lego Mindstorm with a battery pack strapped on top and a Raspberry Pi underneath. And the Raspberry Pi sends signals to the little receiver on top to control the motors. Now, once you have control like that, you can program the Pi to essentially control the robot. It can drive around on its own, semi-autonomously. Currently, I've got this infrared controller, which sends infrared signals from the remote to the receiver on top. This was initially how we received the robot, with a few bits and bobs plugged on top, including the Pi. Then we just hacked together a bit of a solution so that we could automate the control using the sensors instead. We've got a Raspberry Pi on the back, which is Pi Model B, and we've got a breadboard on top, thrown a load of wires on, and we've got an infrared LED which sends out a signal. We pulse this LED at a certain oscillation, which corresponds to the signals you can receive from the receiver on the machine. So that essentially allows us to control the robot itself. We also have some ultrasonic sensors plugged into the front, the back, left and right, obviously on each side. And what we do here is we do Marco Polo, and then we calculate the distance to the objects immediately in front, back, left and right. They send out one signal, and it will bounce off all of the obstacles in the room. It will send a resultant signal back, which will get received by the receiver. So in a sense, it's going Marco and then Polo, getting the signal back. And then the robot does a bit of a naive search and essentially moves in the direction where it's not going to hit things. Now, this isn't perfect. The robot itself is actually quite naive. So the sensors on the front, the back, the left and the right, they're good for about 30 degrees of range. But there are blind spots on the corners and the front and the back by the wheels. Yeah, sometimes this isn't great because you can hit very thin obstacles which the sensors don't necessarily get in range, something such as a pole or something. So it's not perfect, but it's good enough if you want to send it into an environment where you can't necessarily go. Here we're just trying it out with some different objects in a small environment we hacked together. So we've got a small PC and a bit of wood and just a small little cage to drive around in. The idea is that this robot should be able to drive around on its own and not crash on the walls most of the time. Again, not perfect, but it's a good little demonstration of a naive search robot, essentially. So I'm just gonna plug it in to the monitor. We can connect to this wirelessly. This robot's normally set up on a static IP, but due to some difficulties in the new network we've got installed, it's not working right now. So I'm just gonna plug it into the monitor and do it that way instead. So it's a Raspberry Pi Model B, and it's got the standard operating system on, which is I think they call it noobs. In terms of wiring, each sensor has a ground and a 5-volt rail, and then it's got input and output signals. So the white wire is to send a signal to pulse the sensor, and the black wire is to receive a signal back. So essentially each one of these sensors has four cables, and those four cables are powered and controlled by the Raspberry Pi, which is underneath the breadboard. We would have soldered this together, but we were rapid prototyping when we made this and we just wanted to get something that worked. The Raspberry Pi operating system is booted up now, so we should be able to access the command line. I've written a program called Roma in C++, which should allow the robot to drive around semi-autonomously. It's actually doing it now. Such a hack. It's taking in data from the sensors and it's thinking about where it's going to drive. So the idea is it should be constantly polling the sensors in order, seeing what data it can collect from the environment. So this data will consist of distance data around it, more specifically, the measurements are in centimetres. So the sensors themselves have a range of about 4 metres, which means the robot can drive in an area of about 4 metres squared. But again, it's a naive robot, so it may not pick up things below the sensors, or it may not pick up things out of the range of the sensors.
But it's not got a tilt sensor either, has it?
No, there's no accelerometer on it. That would have been something we'd added if we had more time, but...
And I think that's what's called backing yourself into a corner.
Yep. Nothing's perfect.
So it reaches the right depth in your brain. We're taking a baseline now. That means we're asking Max to relax while we take an average of his brain activity.